This is my letter. Send in paradise to Mr. Einstein. I am a poor in spirit in physics, since I am only an architect.
My dear Mr. Einstein, paradise, excuse me, I am poor in my spirit, and I do not understand completely your lesson. You have done this consideration. When calculating kinetic energy, that is work to accelerate a mass from zero speed to some finite speed, relativistically using Lorentz transformation instead of Newtonian mechanics, I, Einstein, have discovered an unexpected byproduct of this calculation to be an energy term which does not vanish at zero speed. I have called it rest mass energy, energy which every mass must possess even when being at rest. I have realized that the amount of energy is directly proportional to the mass of a body. E equal mc2, where m is the mass, c is the speed of light in vacuum, and E is the rest mass energy. Mr. Einstein, I do not well understand this. Why is it this rest mass energy equal to the kinetic energy of the mass? Is it perhaps because energy is in a plane 3 multiplied 3 that can move as the real imaginary 3 divided by 3 equal 1 meter, real in reaction to the imaginary part? If we consider the 6 components of the complex volume 3 plus 3, it is right. The rest mass energy is equal to the mass in unitary real action. But it is not completely true. If we consider that joule equal the power multiplied S, joule energy unit equal to the power in real action for 1 second, this product W multiplied S is a velocity only in this case, W multiplied second squared multiplied second raised to minus 1, because of a velocity is always expressed in second raised to minus 1. It is the speed of a section. Why you, Mr. Einstein, believe that the C-speed must be not referred to its electromagnetic section? Afterwards, if the rest mass energy is equal to the absolute kinetic of the mass, are they two different conditions? Therefore, why have you not added them to have all the energy, which was containing also that rest energy? I do an example. If I divide 10 masses by 9, I obtain one mass plus 10 rise to minus 1 as rest mass. I think that the unity is always 10 multiplied 1/10 equal 1. It is also true that in 1/10 equal rest, if it moves and goes in the second member of the equation, it is inverted in 0 equal rest minus 1/10 or in 1 equal rest multiplied 10. But if we do not add the two members, as in 1 man equal 1 man, where 2 equal men, we have not all the men and all the energies. Don't you think, you too? I think that the rest plus 1/10 in the one area puts it greater than one area, and so 3 multiplied 10 raised to 8 meters cubed advance only 4,299.792.458 meters by this cause. But sorry, I am only a poor architect, a poor man in his spirit, not well knowing the physics. Thanks for your precious contribution, Mr. Einstein. In fact and verity, your Romano Amodeo, New Italic School of Epistemology.
I really hope that by paradise, Mr. Einstein helped me in a way that this letter arrives to the just destination. I really hope it.